Welcome to the class. Hi, dear students. How are you? I hope everyone is fine and healthy and hearty. I am also fine. The students, you all are detached from the school for a long time due to COVID-19. So, with the teachers, I try our best to teach you through online class so that you can study well and continue your study. Well, I am Shukla Dash, assistant teacher, Kabash Kulan City Corporation, Girls High School. Today's lesson is voice. You know very well, voice is a important term in English grammar. So you have to understand voice well. Learning outcomes. After studied, we will be able to know about the definition of voice and its kinds, understand the definition of active and passive voice with examples, know the rules of voice changes. English second paper, class 8, topic voice. Voice changes. In the beginning, we have to know about the definition of voice. What is voice? Voice is a kind of form that shows the domination of a subject or an object, or voice is the form of the verb which indicates whether the subject does the work or something has been done to it. I want to give you some informations about voice. It changes the functions of the subject and the object. It changes the position of subject and object. It changes the form of the verb. Now, we will know about kinds of voice. There are two kinds of voice. They are active voice and passive voice. Now, we will know about the definition of active voice with examples. Active voice tells us what a person or thing does. The subject performs the action on the object. In active voice, at first we put subject, then verb, and then object. Here are some examples. Anna painted the house. The teacher always answers the students' questions. Ali posted the video online. Here you see that in these three sentences, at first we put subject, then verb, and then object. In the first example, we put Anna as a subject, and then verb painted, and object the house. Here Anna does the work, that means she is painting the house. So it is active voice. Now we will know about passive voice. Passive voice tells us what is done to someone or something. The subject is being acted upon. In passive voice, at first we put object, then verb, and then subject. Here are some examples. The first example is the house was painted by Anna. The students' questions are answered by the teacher. The video was posted online by Ali. In these three examples, we see that at first we put object and then verb painted and then subject Anna. Here the work is acted upon the subject. I hope you all have understood very well active voice and passive voice. Now we watch a video regarding the rules of voice changes according to tense.
Passive voice. in English. Tense. Active. Passive. Present simple. I do my homework. My homework is done. Present continuous. I'm doing my homework. My homework is being done. Past simple. I did my homework. My homework was done. Past continuous. I was doing my homework. My homework was being done. Present perfect. I have done my homework. My homework has been done. Past perfect. I had done my homework. My homework had been done. Future simple. I will do my homework. My homework will be done. Future be going to. I'm going to do my homework. My homework is going to be done. Modal. I must do my homework. My homework must be done. Modal perfect. I should have done my homework. My homework should have been done.
Now, we will watch another video regarding change of voice in some different sentences.
Hello friends, welcome to my channel eGrammar. Now, in this video, we are going to see change the voice of some different types of sentences. As in, model auxiliary sentences, imperative sentences or questions. Now let's see what happens when we convert from sentence from active voice to passive voice. There are certain changes in subject or in modal auxiliary words. Let's see. I becomes me, we become us, they becomes them, you remain as you, he becomes him, she becomes her, it remain as it, name remain name. Now in modal auxiliary words, see. Can becomes can be, must become must be, may becomes maybe, might becomes might be, should becomes should be, ought to becomes ought to be, should have becomes should have been, ought to have becomes ought to have been, must have become must have been, might have become might have been, may have becomes may have been. Now let's see sentence first. Now in this video I'm not going to tell you the formula for this, because earlier we have seen all the videos of change the voice. In all those videos I have told you already the formula. Now these are some exceptional sentences or some different types of sentences. Okay, now let's begin for the sentences. Now he should write it, it should be written by him. He can't write it, it can't be written by him. He must write it, it must be written by him. He should have written it, it should have been written by him. He needn't write it, it needn't be written by him. He ought to write it, it ought to be written by him. Understood? Now let's move to the next part. See. Write a letter. Let a letter be written. Let him write a letter. Let a letter be written by him. Do not make the mistake. Let not the mistake be made. Enter by this door. You are requested to enter by this door. Be quiet. You are ordered to be quiet. Put out the light. Let the light put out. Understood? Now let's move to the next part. Who wrote it? By whom was it written? Now in this slide you are going to see all questions. Okay, see. When will you write it? When will it be written by you? Why should you suspect me? Why should I be suspected by you? Where was she making it? Where was it being made by her? Where does he keep his pens? Where are his pens kept by him? Okay. When did he write the book? When was the book written by him? What can he do? What can be done by him? What are you watching? What is being watched by you? Understood? Now let's move to the next part. See some sentences. You must shut the door. The door must be shut by you. There was no time to lose. There was no time to be lost. The result surprised him. He was surprised at the result. A doctor should see her. She should be seen by a doctor. We know this game. This game is known to us. Give the order. Let the order be given. Understood? You must look after him. He must be looked after. Understood? Now let's move to the next part. Switch on the light. Let the light be switched on. Shut all the windows. Let all the windows be shut. We saw them go out. They were seen to go out. Please help the poor. You are requested to help the poor. Do it now. Let it be done now. Now let me tell you first thing. In this video, I am going to tell you some different types of sentence. There might be some differences in active voice and in passive voice. Okay, I hope you might have understand whatever I have told you as far as my knowledge is concerned. Okay, Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe and like the video.
I hope you all have understood well the rules of voice change through these two videos. Now I have given you some examples with answers. In one part there is active voice and another part there is passive voice. Number one, children like chocolates. The passive voice will be, chocolates are liked by children. Number two, children are painting pictures. Pictures are being painted by children. Number three, someone has stolen my pen. Passive voice, my pen has been stolen by someone. You can put someone here, or if you don't want to write down, you can't. Number four, the policeman caught the burglar. The burglar was caught by the policeman. She was writing a story. A story was being written by her. They had won the game. The game had been won by them. The government will pardon him. He will be pardoned by the government. Has anyone seen the postman? Has the postman been seen by anyone? Number nine, did the watchman catch the thief? The passive voice will be, was the thief caught by the watchman? Number 10, will the postman deliver the letters? Will the letters be delivered by the postman? I have given you a homework. Change the voice from active to passive and vice versa. Number 1, they will teach you English. I saw the boy crying. Number 3, he showed me the greatest respect. Number 4, he is going to start a new business. Number 5, do not insult the weak. Number 6, his pen has been stolen. Number 7, he was awarded a gold medal. Number 8, his behavior surprised me. Number 9, he decided to sell the house. Number 10, Penny seized the writer. I request all of you to complete the homework at your home. I want to give you some advice, sir. Please wear your mask when you go outside and stay home, stay safe. In this pandemic condition, I hope you all hail and hearty. Thank you for watching my presentation.